Harris will pledge the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everybody. This is our voting meeting, our monthly voting meeting. I just wanted to report that we held an executive session prior to this meeting, and we addressed legal matters. This is also the time in the meeting that we will entertain public comments. So if anyone would like to make a comment, that would be fine. Hey, Rob.
Hi.
Do I make the comment from here, or do you want me to? You're welcome to come up to the table if you want.
My name is Rob Scaboria. I've lived here in Exeter for 20 years. I have three children that attend high school. Wanted to thank you for an opportunity just to share a brief public comment. In the audience, you'll see we have a number of folks from the Exeter High School water polo team. We have some of our athletes here. We have many of our parents. We have one of our coaches, Coach Tampa, in the back, and two of our board members from our Boosters board organization. Just wanted to share a few thoughts about tonight's agenda. It's my understanding that the board is considering the addition of the coaching positions to come into the list or the other coaching positions that you have here in the district. Just a few highlights of what we've done. As you're probably aware, the program started 2 years ago. We've had a tremendous amount of growth in the last 2 years. We're up to 33 athletes at the high school level. That's 20 girls and 13 boys. We've been able to secure an agreement with Albright College to practice 4 to 5 times a week. Next season, we'll be able to host half our games at home at Albright as well. We completed our first season as a full member of the Pennsylvania Water Polo League Central Conference. We added a girls team, so a JV team, so that there'd be more playing time for the kids. In our first season, the girls registered 5 wins. The boys registered 11 wins and made it to the first round of the playoffs. 5 of our athletes were recognized with postseason awards. We started a middle school program this year, also hosted at Albright. We had 15 athletes from Exeter in grades 5 through 8 playing this fall as well, so they could be prepared to help us in a couple of years at the high school level. We offer 6 free clinics each summer at Antietam Pool. As an effort to get kids into the Exeter area, it's free to all residents. You don't have to be an Antietam Pool member, and we do that for exposure and to spread the word about this great opportunity at the high school. We have a pretty dedicated booster group. We've worked hard to provide most of the resources. We are appreciative of the support that the board and the district provided for us last season by adding in game transportation and also helping us with the purchase of uniforms. So we appreciate that while we're a young team, the board has stepped forward. Tonight's proposal is to add the coaches. If you're familiar with sports, and I'm sure most of you are, the coach is an integral part of helping a program move forward. And by having paid coaches and putting them on the appropriate level with the other coaches, this will allow our program to develop and add more students that can participate and add more opportunities. Many of us in the audience were part of the group back in 2008 when the board graciously approved our swim program. And now you can see the fruits of that labor 8 years later. We were up to 50 athletes last year, many going on to district state competitions. We have kids swimming at Ohio State, Westchester, Bloomsburg, Niagara, Georgia Southern. 4 of our 6 seniors out of our swimming and diving are going to scholarship programs next year with money for swimming and diving. That's 4 out of the 6 seniors. So in 8 or 9 years, that program has developed. And a big part of that is the coaching. Certainly we're a younger program. We're 3 years in next fall, but we ask for your consideration and thank you for considering this item. Certainly I'm here tonight. If I can be of any help or answer any questions when you get to that part, certainly here to help. Thank you.
I do have a question for you, actually.
Sure.
Because you mentioned Antietam Pool, and you know some of you get kids from Antietam and joining us on our sports team. So do you have kids from Antietam?
Yes, we
you
we have a cooperative in place with Antietam, and we're excited that last year we had two team members from Antietam that were students there come over. We expect to have a few more next year because there's some kids in 7th, 8th grade that have been tagging along in the summer. So we certainly have been promoting opportunities for the Antietam school district kids to participate as well.
Thank you. I certainly believe in all the sports that we have here in this district, the music program, the arts, and everything else. But I don't know if most people are aware of what's going on at the state level, but with the elimination of property taxes, we here in Exeter, our board, it will lose all local control of any monies. And unfortunately, it is my opinion that the state is not going to be paying what the residents pay in taxation. And I don't even know if we could even have any programs, any extracurricular programs, if this goes through down the line. Because they're not going to give us the money. That's about $3 billion in debt as they are. And I don't see eliminating at the local control anything will be accomplished. So maybe the people out there that are very interested in these programs need to call their legislators and tell them, you know what, we need to have local control here. If they would pay 50% of the cost of the education for the students here, we would be doing great. But as of now, what is it, about 26% they pay? Do you think they're going to pay 74% more? I doubt it.
So if I was a gambling man, no. I'll be honest.
I know. So, I mean, we all believe here in our extracurricular activities. I mean, we have great programs for the kids, both educationally and, you know, the STEM program. All those programs, they all cost money. We're not going to be able to have that money. So I hope that the community starts calling their legislators. I have to call them every day, tell them the same thing. And, you know, it's like, oh, well, I don't hear from anybody else. So, you know, I would ask the community to do that because we are going to be in dire straits here for any extracurricular activities.
Thank you. Thanks for your comments, Mr. Stewart.
Thank you.
Are there any other public comments this evening? Okay, we'll move on with the agenda. We have two sets of minutes that we'll be approving this evening. One, the board workshop minutes of January 10th and the board voting minutes of January 17th. I'd like to put these two items together, and I move that we approve these two sets of minutes.
Second.
A motion and a second. All in favor, say aye.
I forgot. I'm like one of the students. I forgot the power of my Chromebook, so I don't have it with me. But did you change the minutes where I noted that?
I did.
Okay.
Would you like me to read
No.
it to you?
I trust you.
It made you sound good.
Thank you.
Any further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Treasurer's report.
I move the Treasury's report for 1/31/2017. The following financial statements are attached. The year-to-date summary of revenue and expenditures, all funds, statements of assets, liabilities, and fund balances, payroll and fringe benefits summary, investment statements, and student activity and athletic fund.
Second.
Motion and a second. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, our next section is board policy, and we have several policies again. Several are for approval. I think the first seven are second reading. And I'm going to break these policies into two different categories. The first section are those that are for second reading. That includes policy 007, which is a change to our policy manual access, policy 100, comprehensive planning, policy 101, mission statement, vision statement, shared values, policy 102, academic standards, 103, non-discrimination in school and classroom practices, and 103.1, non-discrimination qualified students with disabilities, 104 non-discrimination in employment and contracted practices. Those are all for second reading. I move that the board approve those seven policies for second reading. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The motion carries. Okay, the second portion of these policies starts out with policy 105, which is curriculum. This will be the first reading. Policy 105.1, review and instructional material by parents, guardians, and students. 105.2, exemption from instruction. 106, guidelines for planned instruction. And policy 823, which is naloxone, which is an anecdote for opioid use. So I move that those four policies move on through first reading.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Okay, business functions, Dr. Hearn.
Item 6A, assistant solicitor appointment. Resolved that the board of school directors appoints Leah A. Rottenberg, Esquire, and Mays Connard and Rottenberg, YMSC, PA, as assistant solicitor for the Exeter Township School District under the same terms and conditions as the solicitorship of John S. Mosley, Esquire.
Second.
Okay, motion and a second. Any discussion?
John, do you have any idea how long you would have her as an assistant? I mean, is this going to, to the end of the school year, or is it going to follow through, or?
I think as long as it's needed, I think that would be the most appropriate way to say it.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Item 6B, it is reported that the Pennsylvania Department of Education approved Plan Con Part J project accounting based on final costs for the Lawton Creek Elementary School. Based on PDE's review of the final cost data for the school construction project, permanent reimbursement rates have been established for related lease numbers.
Second.
Any discussion?
It's just
that's the report. We may not have to vote on that.
Oh, we're not going to vote?
No. It just has to be reported.
Oh, that's just information.
And entered into the minutes.
Okay.
Item 6C. It is recommended that the Board of School Directors approves the Berks County Intermediate Unit Mandated Services Budget for the year 17-18 in the amount of $1,839,160. The budget reflects 0.79% increase of Berks member districts payments for BCIU mandated services over 16-17. Exeter Township School District share of the budget is projected to be $49,677.74, or $788.80 higher than the current year.
Second. Any discussion?
Dr. Davies, do you think you can give us some ideas of some of the mandated services that the BCIU provides to us?
I don't know if I'm the person to answer that question.
I thought that was curriculum.
We provide your instructor support, your professional development for teachers and aides. It provides early intervention. It provides, what else we got?
The litigation piece, the advocacy piece. The connection through Harrisburg, through Dr. Heckman.
All your speech therapists and that sort of thing.
This person.
All right, hold on. We have a list. looks like management services, school services, curriculum development, instructional services improvement, continuing professional education services, pupil personnel services, educational technology services. And there's breakouts from all of those.
Okay. Any further discussion? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Opposed? Motion carries.
Item 6D, approval of budget transfers. It is recommended that the Board of School Directors approves budget transfers for the month of January 2017 in the amount of $24,902.
Second.
A motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Item 6E, resolution celebrating the life and honoring the memory of Don Thomas. Whereas on January 21st, 2017, the Exeter Township School District lost a dear friend and valued member of our district family in the passing of Don Thomas. And whereas Don joined the staff in the mid-1950s during the infancy of Exeter as a 1 through 12 district and was a key contributor to forming a culture that continues to this day. And whereas, in his long history with the Exeter Township School District, Don had a positive influence on so many things. As a teacher, coach, and athletic director, he was completely committed to the success of our students, our student athletes, the school district, and the larger Exeter community. And whereas a classroom teacher, Don created the same enthusiasm in his students that he nurtured on the athletic field. His classroom techniques were designed to draw even the most shy and reclusive student into the educational experience and created a classroom environment that demanded active participation by all students in a group learning experience. He emphasized the opportunities our nation provided, humanized the early history of our nation, and illustrated the need for each individual to contribute to the continuance of our grand experiment through commitment to the founders' principles. Don emphasized the value of patriotism, loyalty to the community, and a team spirit that extended to daily life as well as athletics. And whereas Don was an instrumental in creating the athletic department structure that allowed development of a varsity sports program to establish the district and its students as a force in interscholastic sports in Berks County and Southeast Pennsylvania. He guided and developed our student athletes in a young football program to its first winning season in 1964, and soon thereafter as champions in the Inter-County League. And whereas, as a mentor, Don made every effort to utilize his contacts gained through his collegiate athletic experience in his position as athletic director to provide opportunities to Exeter students. In later life, he was instrumental in forming the alumni organization that continues its efforts to maintain the bonds to the school district and its students with its alumni. And whereas Don's tireless efforts on behalf of the district earned the respect of so many, he was inducted into Exeter's Sports Hall of Fame for his coaching accomplishments, and his many contributions were recognized when the high school stadium was named in his honor. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Exeter Township School District celebrates the memory of our friend Don Thomas and expresses its heartfelt condolences to the entire Thomas family.
Any further discussion?
I would just like to say that it was very well written and beautifully rendered eulogy, really, and I'd like to thank Mr. Quinter, who was an athlete under Mr. Thomas and a student as well, for laying out for those of us who did not know his history and all that he did for the district. And I think it sort of hammers home what Mr. Scaboria was talking about the importance of coaches in people's lives. So thank you for writing that, Bob. It was very well done.
You're welcome, sir. I said Don was a unique individual. In fact, when I was away at the war, I wrote to my parents, I wrote to my wife, and I wrote to Don Thomas. So it's the type of impression that he made on people.
Any further discussion? We have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, we're going to move to Personnel Committee. Dr. Bender.
Part A, we have a rescinded action. I move that the Board of School Directors rescind the December 20th, 2016 appointment of Mark G. Young as administrative building second shift, full-time custodian.
Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Part B, I move that the Board of School Directors approve or ratify the following resignations of administrative staff, certificated staff, support staff, support substitutes, and extracurricular staff.
Second.
Any further discussion?
I'd like to personally thank Jeff McFarland for all the energy he's put into the high school in the past years, working with the fellow staff. His energy with Dr. Davies in putting forth the STEM program, his working with the students to create a collaborative effort to produce a quality product coming out of our schools, which is our students every day. Thank you, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you for the opportunity. It's really been an honor, and I'm going to miss working in a great community with great families, support the board, and our kids. They're great. Thank you for all you've done.
I was going to echo Jim's accolades to you. You've been a stalwart over at the building, and you will be missed, which I think is the measure by which we all have to gauge our contribution. So you will be missed, and I thank you myself. I do have one other question. I see where the junior high softball coach is resigning. Have we got a replacement for that, and when do we have to have it?
We are posting it, and that will be coming as soon as we can get it. It's 10 days from the posting.
Any further discussion? Okay, all in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Part C, I move that the Board of School Directors approve or ratify the following retirements of certificated staff and support staff.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Part D, I move that the Board of School Directors approve or ratify the following appointments of certificated staff, support substitutes, and extracurricular staff.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries.
I'll make an additional motion about appointments because we have another category, even though it's listed as certificated substitutes, are the guest teachers that are not certificated. So I move that we approve the two guest teachers listed under Part D.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed?
No.
Motion carries.
Part E, I move that the Board of School Directors approve or ratify the following leaves of absence of certificated staff and support staff.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Part F, I move that the Board of School Directors approve or ratify the following request for exchange of status of the sports staff listed on the agenda.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Part G, staff conferences. I move that the Board of School Directors approve the staff conferences listed in Part G, number 1 through 12.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Part H, I move that the Board of School Directors approve the changes and additions to the extracurricular salary positions per the attached memo.
Second.
Any discussion?
Is K Can I just jump in here for a second? First of all, two things. For those of you who are attending the meeting for the first time, we don't see a lot of people at our meeting, so we're kind of excited to have you here. We're going to keep you here as long as we can, because I know you have nothing else to do. But this is actually a voting meeting, so you're seeing us flying through an agenda. We had a lot of discussion on these topics last week, so it's not like we're just rubber stamping stuff here. In a workshop meeting, you review a lot of this stuff, and then a meeting like tonight, you've had all your discussion last week. So what you're doing tonight is you're basically just approving that discussion from last week. So we're not just rubber stamping things here. The other thing I'd like to say is what Mrs. PJ brought up is not untrue, but we're not there yet in terms of where we're going with real estate tax exemption. You know, I'm going to steal something from the NRA, but they're going to have to rip the trumpet out of my cold, dead hands before we get rid of extracurricular activities here in the Exeter School District. We're going to fight very hard as much as we can to ensure, because we realize that education is vitally important, what happens in the classroom, but we also develop leaders in the band, in the swimming pool, and on the basketball court, and during plays and all the other things that we do as well. We want to continue, I believe, to have a well-rounded educational and extracurricular opportunities we can provide to our students.
And I would add that there is no bill yet to replace last year's Act 76. We have no idea what that bill would be a form of. When we get guidance from the state so far as any tax actions, then we will make our planning in a deliberate fashion. But when we start talking about any reductions, then we will consider those reductions and make as appropriate. As of right now, there are no reductions planned. There's no law in effect to reduce taxes, and everything is as normal. So there is no need for panic yet.
We'll tell you in the
panic. I'd like to add that the main motion referred to an attachment. On that attachment are the positions that we're voting on at this time. There'll be changes in the track coaching positions. Then the new positions, which we appreciate the community being here tonight, is one boys coach and one girls coach for the water polo teams, an extracurricular co-curricular position for the Nethon, and a co-curricular position for the Forensics Club. So that's what we'll be voting on now.
And I'd like to just add something. I know that Mr. McFarland was involved, but the Minithon this past weekend exceeded its goal from last year, and the excitement and enthusiasm that those hundreds of students had for that program is pretty amazing. And Ms. Bollinger, who has run that program, she ran it the first year uncompensated, and you know, it's like herding cats with high school students. And I think she did an amazing job this year, so I would like to see us support her as well.
Okay, any further discussion? Okay, all in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The motion carries.
That completes personnel.
Thanks, Dr. Brennan. Mrs. Kutcher, student functions. And don't forget your microphone.
Item A is a list of all of the field trips within the 60-mile radius, and I was wondering, I can't find the one now, was it the mock trial, how we did it in the mock trial, have you heard? I think that's what, I think that's hopefully.
Yes, that's from the...
Yeah, February 14th. Did you hear it?
I have not heard. No, I have a whole bunch to talk about, but I haven't heard my comment yet.
Mr. Malsney, did you hear it?
I don't know the exact place that did well. It was a strong event. They're not going to disperse. I don't know the exact place. I did talk to a couple of students, and they did say that it was great, but they didn't tell me exactly the place they got in, so I don't think it was first.
Thank you very much. I think you can't leave now.
Yeah.
Too late.
Item B. There are two events that are going on. The orchestra 12th grade orchestra is going to be traveling to Bangor on March the 8th. And the senior high school varsity wrestling team is going to travel to Central Mountain High School December 2017. I move that, or I'm reporting that, I guess.
Well, you're moving that we.
I should be moving it because it's outside of the 65.
A and B? Items A and B?
No.
No.
1 and 2 under B.
1 and 2 under B.
1 and 2 under B.
Yeah.
Did we take any action on A?
Yeah.
We don't do that. She just reports that.
Okay, it says action on A.
Actually, I thought we were supposed to approve it because it's outside of the 60 mile radius.
Yeah, we're talking about the within the 60 mile.
I don't want to be.
She kind of rolled through both the rest. She's just raising.
You can motion for A.
Oh, no, I'm not talking about A. I'm talking about B, 1 and 2.
Okay, we'll stick here B, 1 and 2.
Yes. And supposedly they're outside of the 60 mile radius.
We have a motion and a second. Any additional discussion on field trips beyond the 60 mile radius? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Item C, I move that the Board of Directors approves a tuition agreement between New Story Kenhorst and the Exeter Township School District Special Education Services for student 221327 beginning January 17th, 2017 through the end of the 2016-17 school year at a cost of $299 a day.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
We have one opposed. Motion carries.
Item D, I move that the Board of Directors approve a tuition agreement between New Story Wyomissing and the Exeter Township School District for special education services for student number 170695 beginning January 24th, 2017 through the end of the 2016-17 school year at a cost of $376 per day.
Second.
Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
All opposed? Motion carries.
Item E, reporting that Scott Cabone, a senior, has been given permission to attend Exeter Schools, Township School Senior High as a non-resident student the remainder of the 16-17 school year in accordance with policy 202 eligibility of a non-resident student. Item F, I move that the Board of Directors approves a contract with Emotional Wellness LLC to provide mental health services to qualifying students in the Exeter supported cyber school program at no cost to the district.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Item G, I move that the Board of Directors approves the 2017-18 Soaring Eagle Program of Studies catalog for the senior high school students and staff.
Good. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Item H, I move that the Board of Directors approves the 2017-18 Soaring Eagle Program of Studies catalog for junior high school students and staff.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Item I, I move that the Board of Directors adopts the 2017-18 school calendar.
Second.
Discussion.
Actually, I do have a question. Can you tell me where on this the additional 2 hours should set aside for professional development is shown on this calendar? If it's not there.
It should be on those Fridays.
There's 12 of them.
Okay. There's 12.
Okay, that's good. Okay.
And we've now termed PD days, so it will coincide with what the state is looking for us. No, you're right. You said it right.
And then for these early early dismissal days, that's not gonna be a problem for the BCTC kids in the afternoon that are in the afternoon program?
There's no change from the way we've done that in the past.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Any additional discussion? If not, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Item, J. I move that the Board of Directors approve the tuition agreement between Opportunity School and Education Program of Elwin, Inc. and the Exeter Township School District for Education Services for student number 290193, beginning February the 21st, 2017, through the end of the 2016-17 school year, at a cost of $159 a day.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
That's it.
Thank you, Mrs. Kutcher.
You're welcome.
We're gonna move to curriculum programs, curriculum committee, Mr. Kutcher.
As I stated last week, we did discuss the taking one-to-one program down to the Rifton. That'll be a phase-type approach as the students demonstrate the maturity and the ability to handle it. And we discussed abandoning the numerical system and going to the Latin description so far as the scholastic performance of our children at the high school. Again, that will be formalized in a proposal brought forward by the curriculum committee. We have our next meeting on 7 March. You're all invited.
Thank you, Mr. Wood. Technology Committee, Mrs. Payton.
The IRATE bids have been collected for 2017-18 telecommunication projects, Wi-Fi wiring, and emergency backup have been approved last week. The Form 471 to accept the quotes will be available next week and with a July 1 purchase date. Online student registration software is progressing well and should go to go live in mid-March. Lifton's 101 is planning for 101 in the 17-18 school year. It was presented at the last curriculum meeting. Migration from Outlook to Google for enterprise mail solutions will begin this spring, eliminating significant costs from IT budget and future budgets. Replacement of district-wide phone system will start as soon as current year E-rates funding is received.
Thank you, Mrs. Payton. IU Board, Mr. Quinter.
No report, sir.
Mr. Trapina, Athletic Committee.
Sure, just a quick update. The girls volleyball and tennis teams, as well as the wrestling team and our cheerleaders, both were county champions. Wrestling also was a district champion. Individual swim and wrestling championships are underway over the next couple of weeks. And I've asked Mr. Legath to bring some of those athletic groups for acknowledgement at the board at a future meeting.
Did you get the bowling results?
Bowling, boys won and girls lost, yes. I believe.
So the boys are moving on.
So the boys move on.
Legislative liaison, township liaison, Mr. Quinter.
No report, sir.
Okay. BCTC is Mr. Diesinger. I don't think there's an, and you aren't aware of anything that was happening. Okay. Facilities Committee, Mr. Brady.
Initially, we were going to plan a meeting for March 16th for the next Facilities Committee meeting due to some conflicts and schedules between the consultant and some of the board members and subcommittee members. We're going to be moving that meeting forward, and a date will be coming out in the near future.
At that next meeting, we will be discussing further with the consultant specifics of the facility's overall evaluation and recommendations moving forward for our game plan for the next 10 years of improvements and modifications.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Brady. Audit Committee, Mrs. Baker.
No.
Payment request, Mrs. Baker.
We have a total of payments from the general fund of $983,496.26.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Yes, on page, we may not have the answer for this earlier. I think Dr. Miller's here. I didn't see her in the audience this evening.
On page?
She's here. I'm sorry, I couldn't see you. You're hiding behind everyone there. On page four, there's an indication of a $34,628.90 bill for special education pediatric therapeutic services. Is that something that we can then apply for reimbursement against the state or reimbursement against the insurance company, or is that totally footed by Exeter? What does that involve? What kind of services do we provide for that?
Therapy services provide our speech therapy programming and a little bit of our department services. And speech services we can apply to access billing for that to get some reimbursement for that.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, sir. Superintendent's report.
Thank you. Hamburger. We've had a very successful month, so bear with me. Congratulations to Amy Schmale for receiving 1 gold and 2 silver key awards, and Juliana Delenner for receiving 1 silver key award at the East Central Pennsylvania Scholastic Art Show. Congratulations to the following students for having artwork accepted into the Yoakum Art Institute's Juried Art Show. The show opening and award ceremony was held January 22nd. Madison Sakonis, Maya Sims, Amy Schmale, Kyle Rockoff, Hannah Rissler, Olivia Oatman, Brianna Graf, Kayla Erb, and Joanna Diener. I'll just read the email from Mrs. Cook. Said, read below, we made the top 10, and there was about 8 exclamation points. I'm extremely proud to announce the 2016 Top 20 Community Walk Events, and this is in the country. Diana Bogus, which is our phys ed teacher up at Owatin, organized an Owatin Creek Elementary School Walk for Diabetes. We came in 8th in the country and 1st in Pennsylvania, so it was extremely, extremely great job. The Berks County Technical Center Students of the Quarter, the second quarter, the East Campus, Aaron Sidrovitz in Cosmetology, Autumn Schabener in Culinary Arts. West Campus, Ryan Loader, Communication Media Technology, Olivia Merkel, Graphics Imaging Technology. The Lions Club gave each Lorraine third grade student a dictionary, and they held its annual Hearts for Hunger campaign. They collected 1,066 food items to donate to the Exeter Food Pantry. Last year they collected 778 items, so they really went above and beyond. 5 members of the PA Governor's STEM competition team placed 2nd at the regional competition at the BCIU. Although this means the team will not be moving on to the state level competition, this is the best finish of the competition so far, surpassing our third place winners from 2 years ago.
Excuse me, Dr. Fuss, can I suggest that maybe we invite the STEM group to demonstrate for us the project that they created? Because I think it was kind of cool, and I think it'd be interesting for us to see that.
That is planned for the curriculum committee. And this is from Mr. Laura. The Small But Mighty Technology Student Association team competed at the Region 9 Conference at Stroudsburg High School. They had many top 10 finishers, but the following are Exeter's top 5. Fifth place team event biotech design, Elizabeth Good, Faith Kahindi, Sai Kurapati, and John Kim. Fourth place team children's story, Michelle Wang and Yashika Kagathapu, sorry if I'm butchering your name. Third place promotional design, Yashika Kagathapu. Second place dragster design, Anthony Nguyen. And first place team fashion design, Amy Schmail, Sai Kurapati, and Elizabeth Good. The individuals and teams are qualified for the state competition in April. Congratulations to Emiliana Landrin for winning the Committee Choice Award for the Berks Art Alliance's Fast Lane Contest. Her artwork will be featured on the electronic billboard on Route 422. As recognized in the Reading Eagle, Gabrielle Bouvai, grade 12 Exeter Township High School senior, for her many accomplishments. And she was the Science Student of the Month. That is my report. Thank you.
We did have a lot.
We're doing some really great things in the district.
And it's not all just sports. There's a lot of academics.
That's true.
As well. It's great.
Is the small but mighty team number of participants or their size?
Participants.
I believe it was a little both, but it was more participants.
Okay. And they'll be coming to the curriculum meeting as well. Okay.
Before we adjourn, I just want to announce that the board will be having an executive session following this meeting to discuss personnel matters. And I will accept a motion for adjournment. This is approved.
Second.
We're adjourned. Thank you.
I just want to say thank you, everybody. Appreciate your support. Thank you very much. How are you doing?
Good.